Like I said, my original intentions were to just narrate a baneful encounter, but I wanted to have somebody do some original illustrations if I could, but that turned out to be really way expensive. So I am gonna come up with something else. I just gonna ask your patience and I'll get it out just as quick as I can. As far as the channel goes, I certainly hope I can get it back to its original status. There goes an idiot right there with no headlights. I deal with that every night here, every night. As far as the channel goes, I certainly hope I can get it back to its original status, like where I can get into it. I guess it's just gonna take a little patience. I'm waiting on Google to get back with me and I have had some help with YouTube already, with the YouTube community giving me some instructions. So I'm just gonna have to wait and see how it all pans out. So if you're watching this on Fat Daddy for Fun, just disregard everything I just said. If you're not, you know, you know what happened. I'm thinking I might have a couple of minutes to swing in here and get a chicken sandwich at Burger King. I've got a lot of plans this autumn, this coming autumn, for some videos. I'm not a I'm not one of those really a Bigfoot fanatic or anything. I do find the whole thing interesting. I'm not a Bigfoot fanatic or anything, but I do find the whole thing interesting, and I really enjoy camping in places that have had a sighting. So I plan on doing that this autumn. There's some stuff in Southeast Oklahoma that have been on network television and stuff. There's some areas in Southeast Oklahoma that have had some Bigfoot sightings, and I have full intentions of doing some camping down there just as soon as I can. It'll probably be later in the season. Like I was saying, I belong to a Bigfoot forum even. I just like to see what people have to say about the subject. I'm not a believer, but I'm not a disbeliever either. I do think there's something that people are seeing and reporting, and a lot of it I'm sure is due to people's overactive imaginations, but initially, and when I say initially, I'm talking hundreds of years ago, you know, Native Americans saw the same thing. Yeah, Bigfoot's been around a long, long time. He's not a new discovery at all. I heard somebody ask one time on that show, what is it called, Finding Bigfoot? Somebody asked those Bigfoot hunters, or those Bigfoot searchers, asked them, how come there's no fossil evidence for Bigfoot? And I found out that there hasn't been fossil evidence for the African chimpanzee until 2003. But regardless of what that rascal is, there's no doubt in my mind that there is something in those woods up there, especially up there in the Olympic Forest and the Washington area around Mount St. Helens. There's absolutely something up there. I don't know what it is, and I'm not going to put any labels on it, but there's no doubt in my mind it's been reported and seen for hundreds of years, so there's some kind of other species up there that we don't know about. And Washington and Oregon don't hold a monopoly on these creatures either. There are sightings all over the world. We have many reports right here in southeastern Oklahoma near a place called Ho Nubby. It's spelled Honobia, but they pronounce it Honobi for some reason. They even have a Bigfoot festival there and a conference every fall. So, in southeastern Oklahoma, there's a huge expanse of wilderness area, and a lot of it is remote and really hard to get at. It's hard to get through. It's full of crags and rocks and mountains and caves and just all kinds of just a very harsh, remote area. And people go missing there all the time. And when I say people, I mean like whole families wind up missing down in that area sometimes. And so regardless of the big furry fella, there's a real threat in that area. And this fall, I'm going to do some camping there. And the sole purpose is to get some YouTube video for you guys. It should be scenic and very scary. I've never been there before, but I'm pretty confident in my abilities. And I will have the aid of the latest technology in two-way communications, GPS, Glock, and Mossberg. So, it's going to be like a light to medium pack venture, you know, meaning I'll have my cooking gear along. And if I'm solo, I'll be in a hammock. If not, and I have company, I'll most likely set up a tent. Now, if my daughter comes along with her friend, I'm going to promise you a funny video, because I am literally going to scare the hell out of those kids. And I'll have it all on video for you guys. So it should be a genuine Fat Daddy outdoor camping adventure, Roger. Now, along the same lines, I'm going to give you this little announcement. I'm going to continue to produce the videos with the survival theme and the format that I've always used. But in addition, I'm going to stray a little bit and do some videos along the lines of some of my other interests, which are the dark and scary ones. I won't be placing any labels on any encounters, but let's just call them trips to the unknown, because that's essentially what they are. I'm not sure about the title yet, but I'll probably label them something like Wolf in the Darkness video or something to that nature. I'm going to just seek and explore some phenomenon of unknown origin in my region, in my area. And I may even venture out of my area a little bit, but I'm going to try and camp in these areas if I can for, you know, a really good overnight experience. People say, Wolf, you're a level-headed guy. I didn't know you believed in ghosts and demons and spooks and Bigfoot. And you know what? Because I'm a level-headed guy, it's not that I believe in those things, but I'm not going to disbelieve them just because there's a lack of evidence, you know. The absence of evidence is not the evidence of absence. You guys remember that. You know, just because science can't prove it doesn't mean it doesn't exist. So, I just try and keep an open mind about these things. And, I know y'all really dig those camping videos, and I love to make them, but man, I'm having a hard time getting out camping because of these triple-digit temperatures. We're like in our, you know, 100 straight days of it. And I'm a shut-in, a recluse when it comes to the heat like that. You know, I'll camp with ice on the ground, but when it's triple-digit temperatures, I am locked in a nice, cool apartment with the blinds drawn, and it's movie time. I'm certainly not going camping in it. But those are my plans for the future. As far as my channel update goes, I'm going to expand a little bit. I am going to be attempting to camp in some of these spots. I'm going to talk about the paranormal. That's what I'm going to talk about. And I'm going to talk about Bigfoot. And I'm not going to do it because it's popular or unpopular. I am going to do it because I think it's fascinating. And I'm going to label those videos so y'all will know I think I mentioned before, I might call them like a wolf after dark or wolf in the dark or something like that, you know. So you will know that this is a video with spooky subject matter or strange subject matter. And if you're not interested in that kind of thing, cool. You know, hang out and wait for the next camping video or whatever I'm doing. I've never been one to just have a standard format. Y'all know I make videos on all kinds of crap, you know, from tornadoes to snowstorms to camping. On my, you know, I even shoot videos of my truck. I'm a Patriot Guard rider support, so I make videos on the Patriot Guard riders and honoring our fallen soldiers. And I'll make a video on anything.
We're gonna go camp in some weird, strange places. Just to add a little nuance to our normal camping adventures. It ought to be fun. It'll be a rush if nothing else. Idiot. So we might go walk to the old abandoned scary house or investigate the mystery lights or go camping where the latest Bigfoot sighting's been. Like I said, you know, we're not gonna jump to conclusions. We're gonna keep an open mind about things, and we're really not there to prove or disprove anything. I mean, I could do a whole video on that show, Ghost Hunters, honestly. So we're just gonna have a good time. That's gonna add a little something something to our video. Roger. All right. So, we're gonna check out some ghosties and some aliens and the big furry fella. And I hope you're gonna enjoy it.
Hey, there's something down there. You see that in the clearing?
Oh, yeah. You're lazy, just stay in bed.